on Monday as far as like the appearance of our station. Going good. observing me. He was like more observing like all the new changes and things like that. So he was like, pretend I'm not here. And I'm like, yeah, okay. So he's in the back, and then another one comes and sits right next to me between me and my producer. And he was there because we were having problems with our cameras. Like sometimes they were too dark, too light or whatever. So he was there observing the cameras. So now, say the show starts at 5 o'clock p.m. We technically start the show at 4:59. And we have a clock right on one of our big screens that counts down, the hours, the minutes, and the seconds. Because in a TV studio, you basically tell time by seconds and not by minutes, which sucks. But so we have that, and then directors have a little monitor on the side that basically counts you down. Like, it's not just a regular clock, like it literally counts you down by the second to when a commercial break starts and when a commercial break ends. And that's the monitor that we usually use to count down, the people, going live. 15 to stand by in 10, and then I'll count them down from 5. So my manager, who was there to look at the cameras, he asked me, he said, can I use this monitor for something else? Like, can I use it to something called a scope, where it basically shows you in a different way, like the lighting of the cameras and whether it's too bright, too dark. He said, can I use it for the scope, or do you need it? Me being an idiot was like, oh no, you can use it, I'll just look at the clock up there. He goes, okay, great. So I start counting them down, minute, 30 seconds, and then I don't know what happened, because I didn't have the monitor, so I should have been looking at the time, but I just stopped thinking, because normally I would look at the other monitor. And I'm talking to my producer, I'm talking to, the anchor and whatever. And all of a sudden, I hear the anchor and the weatherman, they both go, we're live at 59. And they're like trying to like get my attention. And they're like, Sam, we go live at 59. And I looked at the time, and it was 4:59 and like 10 seconds. And I didn't start the show in time. And I was like, oh my god. So I just like, we just jumped into it and started the show like 10 seconds late. So basically, if you are at home watching the news, what that would look like to you is, the news starts at 5 o'clock. So it's 5 o'clock, and right when it's supposed to start, you see the little logo of our station and the corners and whatever, but it's just black. There's no visual. There's no sound. 15 seconds. That's bad. That's really bad. We call that being in black, and being in black is like one of the worst things you can do on TV. And yep, I've never done that in my life ever. In the year and a half that I've been there, I have never done that. But of course, when two of my managers are in the control room, it happened. And my producer was like, yeah, what the heck is happening? Is going on. And so we went into the show, whatever, and then my manager was nice, though. He was like, I'm sorry if I messed you up by taking your monitor. And I'm like, no, like, I still should have been able to look at the clock and be able to count myself down. Like, I shouldn't need a countdown. But it's just the fact that it was out of my norm, and it just, I don't know, threw me off. The manager in the back, the big one, he didn't say anything. So whatever. The rest of the show was perfectly fine. And my manager, who was sitting to my right at the end, he said, to me and my producer, he said, good show, guys. Like, I was impressed. And I was like, inside scoop into how news works. I guess I can't speak for every news station, but I can't imagine that we're the only news station that does it. But basically, when mistakes happen, you're able to edit them in post, which basically means as soon as you're not live anymore, you can go in the back. We have computers that are meant to edit mistakes. They're called fixes. And so, for example, yesterday, you know, the 5 o'clock show ended and I went to go trim that 15 seconds of black where I went up late. You can trim that out. You can cut it out. Just like I edit these videos, you cut something out, you cut that out. And so for all the re-airs, because the next show wasn't until 7, so it re-airs 3 times. It's half an hour long. It airs at 5:30 again, 6 and 6:30. And you don't want that mistake to keep re-airing, because they will keep re-airing unless you fix them. So even though the shows aren't live anymore after 5 p.m., we can still make changes to them and fix them. So if you've ever been watching the news and you see a mistake and then you realize like it's not in the re-air, it's because they fixed it. Which I didn't know that before I started working there. Idea that that was a thing. I did not know that you could, like, do fixes, as they're called. Which, when I first started working there, I remember I was like, that's cheating, but it's really necessary. I'll tell you another one of my big screw-up stories, because I have enough of them. So one day, this is when I was relatively new, though, but one day, we had a scheduling mistake. They thought that I was working. They had me written down to work one day, right? In the schedule. I was not aware that my name was on the schedule. I think they thought that I said I could, but I did not. So, I had to be there at 4 a.m. for that shift that I was scheduled for. But not knowing, I was like out with a friend or someone the night before, and I didn't get home until like 1. Just went to sleep, and everyone is blowing up my phone at like 4:15 in the morning, and they're like, where are you? And I'm like, what do you mean? I'm sleeping. But because I was relatively like new then, I kind of took the blame for it, and I was like, oh my god, I had no idea, I'm so sorry, I'm on my way. So I got there, I had like an hour and a half of sleep, because I didn't go to bed as soon as I got home, so I had an hour and a half of sleep. I didn't even put any makeup on. I threw on a shirt and jeans, and I ran out of my house. Back then, I lived 20 minutes from my job, so I was able to get there in not too much time. And so my first show that I went into, you have to remember, I was very tired. I was not with it. Plus, I was relatively new, so I was like, kind of still like a skittish cat. Like, I was very nervous, because live TV is a beast, and if you're new and you're not used to it yet, it's terrifying. So I go into my first show. It was the 6:30 a.m. show. I accidentally loaded the wrong show into the computer in the control room. I loaded the 7:30 show. Now, because that show wasn't supposed to go live for another hour, it was blank. Videos in it, really. Like, there was nothing, there was no graphics loaded, nothing. So I go into the show, 6:30 comes around, I go into the show, things aren't matching up, the script is not matching the videos, everything is weird and awkward, and it's just not working. We get to weather, he does weather, and then traffic comes right after, and the poor girl, this traffic reporter, she was there for maybe like 2 weeks at this point, like she was new too. And because there are no graphics loaded in that show yet, because it's nowhere near ready, I put the poor girl up she kind of just like froze and like didn't know what to do, and she was like, it looks like, you know, we're having some technical difficulties, but like I don't really know what's happening. And I was like, oh my god. And I was like, I don't know. And we have like a little intercom, like walkie-talkie thing where I can talk to the other director in the other room, in like the director's room. And I was like, oh my god, you need to come in here right now, I don't know what to do. So eventually he came. Liked me.